autistic people often unemployed? Only 15% of autistic people are employed, which is a crazy number. Now, I'm not going to talk about every single reason why it might be hard for an autistic person to get a job and keep a job, but I will give you my experience. Hi, if you've never seen my face before, my name is Morgan. I'm autistic, and I like to talk a lot about autism on here because I think awareness is really important. So I am 22 years old and I just graduated college not even a year ago, and so I haven't had like a corporate office job before, and honestly I do not plan on joining the corporate world because it feels like such like a little club, like you have to be a really specific type of person to get in, and I know that I am not that person because of my autism. But I have worked customer service jobs since I was like legally allowed to work, which I think was like 15, and just from my experience in like casual customer service roles, I know that the corporate world is so not for me. I always started out as the star employee at wherever I was working because I was told that you need to give 110%, and my little autistic brain took that very literally, and I would give 110%, meaning that I was giving more energy than I physically had to offer. I was always completing my tasks very quickly, doing extra things, helping other people with their tasks, asking for more tasks, just really going above and beyond, and I became like the favorite or star employee very quickly, and I would often get like a small little promotion, like I might get keys to open the shop, or I would become like a shift manager or something like that. Like I would excel very quickly because of how much effort I was putting in. I was also told that I was not allowed to stand around, and so I was running from thing to thing. And if I didn't have something that I was doing in that moment, I was scared that I was going to get in trouble because I couldn't stand around and I would take on other people's responsibilities. And like, it was crazy. I was working so hard. But obviously that amount of effort in a job is not sustainable. You're going to burn yourself out. And I would burn myself out. I would go from star employee to moderate employee to unreliable employee in the span of like a year. And then I would hit total burnout to the point that I could not even show up for my shifts because of how mentally exhausted I was from the amount of effort that I was putting in, and also the fact that I was not getting any accommodations. And so when I hit that total burnout, I would become an unreliable employee and I would start to call out all of the time. And I myself am really, really scared of rejection. And I was so scared that my boss would yell at me for calling out. So when I started hitting like total burnout and I would have to call out all the time, I would just up and quit because I don't want you to yell at me. I don't want you to be mad at me. I'm so sorry for like wasting your time. I'm so sorry for being a bad employee. I'm just gonna quit because I don't want you to yell at me. And I would just repeat this cycle over and over and over again in every new job that I had. And I think I've had like 8 to 10 jobs from the age of like 15 to now as like a 22-year-old. Another big issue that I had was that I was unable to navigate the social atmosphere of like working and coworkers and bosses. I really struggle with communication in a lot of different ways, and this would cause a lot of issues and also drain my mental energy because I was trying to overcompensate for my struggles. My communication struggles showed up and caused issues in a lot of different ways. So the first one being that I needed very specific instructions. Nothing could be left for interpretation. If I was not super clear on what I needed to do, I would freeze up and be unable to proceed because I know that my assumptions are always wrong. I need you to tell me. And this caused a lot of miscommunication, especially like with bosses, and I would seem lazy because I would just sit there waiting for further instructions and they didn't understand that I needed further instructions, and it was annoying to them that they had to like explain themselves constantly and give me very specific instructions. So that was always an issue. Another thing is that I don't understand social cues, and I was often telling my coworkers ways that they could improve their job and nitpicking what they were doing. And apparently this is not acceptable, and it made me very much disliked by everyone. I didn't know how to navigate relationships with my coworkers at all. I really struggle with black and white thinking when it comes to different types of relationships. And so I saw my coworkers as, okay, this is a coworker relationship. It needs to be kept surface level and conversation should be about the job. But in reality, that's not like totally how coworkers interact. And so I think I was seen as very like cold or distant because I was giving very surface level communication and nobody was ever like getting to know me. And I wasn't asking personal questions or like seeming like I cared about them. I also just can't make small talk for 8 hours during a shift. I can't do it. I don't understand how you think that there's that much to talk about. I don't want to talk to you about the weather for 20 minutes. Because I'm trying to do my job. And I was probably seen as such a cold and distant person. And looking back, I understand why, but I can't help it. Ooh, I also spoke to everybody the exact same way, and I did not treat any bosses or higher authority with any extra respect because that doesn't make sense to me. I know that that's socially what's supposed to happen and how you're supposed to like kiss up to your boss, but my brain cannot comprehend it. If you aren't doing anything extra to deserve that extra respect, like you're not getting it. Like I am a respectful person. I treat everybody with respect, but you're not gonna get extra above and beyond effort of me trying to give more respect. Especially if you're not deserving it. Like, I need to get to know you. I just don't automatically give it to you. And I had some bosses very much dislike me because of that. And I never really understood it because they'd be like, oh, stop giving me attitude. You're not respectful. And I was so confused because I was being respectful. I was treating everybody with respect. So I was always confused about that. And then there were a lot of issues with accommodations. Even though there are laws in place to make sure that employees are given accommodations that they need. But to be fair, most of the time I was undiagnosed. I did not know that I had autism and ADHD, but I was very vocal about accommodating myself because I knew that I had struggles, but I didn't have a name for it. So I was very vocal about, hey, if you want me to do this job to the best of my abilities, I would like it if you did X, Y, and Z for me to help me do my job better. And the type of accommodations that an autistic person may need in a job setting seems very strange to people if they don't know anything about autism. Like, the type of accommodations that I was asking for were usually around, like, uniforms. Like, since it was a customer service role, like, there was a specific thing that you had to wear. And I would ask for accommodations because something was very uncomfortable or because I felt like I couldn't do my job because I was so uncomfortable all the time. And it was really disrupting the way that I was working. I remember I worked at a fast food place and they made us wear, like, visor hats. And that was horrible for me. I don't know what it is. I can't wear hats. And I would ask if I could just not wear my hat because it had nothing to do with about my hair because it was just a visor. Like it wasn't doing anything like sanitary wise. It was just for appearance. So I said, hey, is it okay if I don't wear my hat? Because it really bothers me. I feel like I can't see. I feel like I'm not working good enough because of it. And they were like, no. What do you mean? Like, it's the uniform. Of course you can't take off your hat. And I thought that was very strange. Another accommodation that I asked for was when I was working in a restaurant and we had like specials. We had a special menu and it would change like every like 3 to 4 days. And so I went in one day and said, hey, I have a really hard time like adapting to the specials menu when you tell us the new specials 10 minutes before we open. Like I don't have enough time to memorize it. I don't have enough time to get familiar with it. It makes me really anxious. Can you give me the schedule of the new specials and whatever ahead of time so I can mentally prepare? And they looked at me like I was crazy. They were like, what? No. To be fair, the specials were reliant on like what type of extra food they had laying around. So like they probably actually didn't know that far in advance. But yeah, I was not being accommodated when I asked for accommodations that I knew I needed. Like, I wasn't asking for silly things to just, you know, get extra perks. Like, these were things that would have actively made my job easier and made me a better employee. And they were never taken seriously because autism accommodations aren't the norm. People aren't used to them, and they seem strange to people that don't understand autism. Another struggle that I've come across about trying to get a job is the job interview process. There was actually a study done, and I don't remember what it's called. If I find it, I'll put it on the screen or I'll link it down below, where they studied if people could recognize autistic people just by interacting with them. And the study concluded that, like, yes, people could pick out autistic people or people that they thought were, like, weird or strange out of a group of people very quickly. And so the interview process is probably discriminatory because the interviewer can probably tell that either I'm autistic or that there is something else going on. And I learned that no matter how qualified you are for a job, the socialization and just like chit chat of an interview is like equally as important as like your credentials and your past employment and like how qualified you are for that job, which it doesn't make sense to my autistic brain because I think very literally and the rest of the world thinks in like a social kind of way, and oh, it doesn't make sense to me. So as a new college graduate who is autistic and also in burnout, I did not even try to join the corporate world or climb that corporate ladder because I've been told from other autistic people who are very successful in a career that the only reason that they are successful in that career is because it is part of their special interest, like they are doing something that they love to do, because that's another struggle that a lot of autistic and or ADHD people experience, where it is very hard for us to stay focused on a job or stay motivated in a job if it's not something that we love doing. This is actually diagnostic criteria for autistic people where we get very hyper-focused and we cannot switch our focus. And so it is very difficult for me to punch in and punch out of a job and just, you know, like make my money and get through it when I'm not in love with it, because I can't switch my focus out of what I'm obsessed with. And so the special interests that I have, I knew would not do me good in the corporate world. They do not like correlate whatsoever. And so I was like, oh geez, I'm gonna have to find something that I am really obsessed with and in love with and find a way to make a career out of that. And that's how I fell into doing social media. I've always been more of like the creative thinker and I'm good with my hands. And one day I started talking about autism on the internet and people liked it. And now this is my full-time job, which is so cool and so amazing. And also not part of the plans. This is not something that I ever thought I would be doing, but it's actually really perfect for me. Now, even with a perfect job that is accommodating to you and it's something that you love, it is still hard to work as an autistic person. I still struggle, even though I'm my own boss and I work from home and I do social media stuff and just, you know, edit. Like, it's still hard because of how much work we end up putting into it. And it's very hard to juggle all of life as an autistic person because our brains are wired differently and we quite literally can't handle as much as other people. And so that puts a strain on your life. Like, if you are working full time, it's hard to then balance out the rest of your life. I know a lot of autistic people that like do work like in a corporate setting or like an office job, and they say that their whole life revolves around working. Like, they are unable to take care of themselves like outside of work, and they're struggling in all other areas of their life, but they're doing really good at their job. And that's because like we can't do all of it. We really can't. And I'm starting to see myself struggle with that too, because I know that people think it, like, social media is like really easy because you just set up a camera and like you film yourself, but there's actually a lot that goes into it. Like, I write scripts, I have to do emails, there's a lot of editing, and also I'm autistic. All of this stuff takes extra long for me, and I also struggle with verbal communication. So this is like my fifth take of filming this video. It's like 6 o'clock at night and I've been doing this since like 10 a.m. It's really hard to find the energy to feed yourself a meal after you've worked all day. So I guess to sum up this video, the world needs to be more accommodating for autistic people because a lot of us have the credentials and like the abilities to get these jobs. The things that are often preventing us are lack of accommodations in our lives as a whole and being able to navigate like the social dynamics when it comes to an office setting and just discrimination. To all my corporate autistics, I applaud you and I hope that you are doing okay. And to all my autistics who are struggling to find work or in that like consistent burnout cycle of being unable to like hold down a job for a long period of time, I feel you, you're not alone. Try to do some like internal work of like figuring out exactly what you may need and then like finding a job off of that. And also trial and error, like it's okay. Oh, and the one thing that I didn't touch on in this video is like comorbid disorders, because I was focusing on like why it's hard to be employed as an autistic person, but autistic people often have comorbidities, meaning that they have other disorders that show up like with autism. So it might be like physical disabilities or like intellectual disabilities or other developmental disabilities. Like I myself also have ADHD and dyslexia and CPTSD, and those things also make finding and maintaining a job hard in different ways. So yeah, I hope this video isn't like scary or depressing for anybody, because that was not my intent. I meant to, you know, shed light on some issues that I've had in my work career and to like help people navigate what might be best for them if they're also autistic. So I hope that's the takeaway that you had. And let me know in the comment section down below if you have a job that like you think is perfect for autistic people, or any like, you know, funny autism moments that you've had at work, because I would love to hear it. Thank you for watching today's video, and I really appreciate you for being here, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!